Let's talk about the Rank-Nullity Theorem, or the Rank Theorem, as it's called in the book. So the Rank Theorem for matrices. Suppose I have a matrix A. Then the rank of A plus the dimension of the null space of A is equal to the number of columns of A. So this dimension of the null space of A, that's often called the nullity of A, which is why this is sometimes called the Rank-Nullity Theorem. So remember, the rank of A is just the dimension of the column space of A. And we saw in an earlier video that that's just the number of pivot columns of A. The dimension of the null space of A, from thinking about row reduction and how we get the solution set to the homogeneous equation AX equals zero, the dimension just corresponds to the number of non-pivot columns of A. And so you see that if you take the number of pivot columns and add it to the number of non-pivot columns, then you get the number of columns of A. So again, we're seeing row reduction, even though we're not doing it explicitly on the matrix, gives us a theoretical tool for understanding these objects. So why is such a theorem important or useful, right? So this theorem is relating the sum of two numbers to a third number. And such theorems are useful when we know two of them, and then we can just solve for the third, right? And so these problems are going to be set up so that in some way you can understand two of those three numbers that arise, and then by the rank theorem, you can conclude what the third one is. So let's take a look at an example. Suppose A is a 9x8 matrix, and you know that the rank of A is 7. What's the dimension of the solution set of AX equals 0? Well, by the Rank-Nullity Theorem, the rank of A plus the dimension of the null space of A is just the number of columns of A. So we have that 7 plus the dimension of the null space of A is equal to 8. And then we just solve. And we see that 8 minus 7 is 1. And so the solution set to AX equals 0 is one-dimensional. Let's look at another example. Suppose I have t from R4 to R. It's the linear transformation given by t of x is 2x1 minus x2 plus x3 minus 7x4. What's the dimension of the solution set of tx equals 0, right? This homogeneous equation. Well, t of x is ax, where a is this matrix 2 minus 1, 3 minus 7, right? So a is just the standard matrix for this linear transformation. I can see the pivot there, and so I see that the rank of the matrix is 1. So then the solution set to tx equals 0 is just exactly the null space of this matrix A. And so the rank of A plus the dimension of the null space of A is the number of columns of A by the rank theorem, and so 1 plus the dimension of the null space is equal to 4. And so then I can just solve for the dimension of the null space, 4 minus 1 equals 3.